Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic respiration in animals and plants, and now in this session we will see how plants respire and what is the role of respiratory mechanism in human beings. Okay, now let's start with the respiration in plants. You know, plants also require energy, right, like other animals, and to perform their life functions. And plants use their energy, or you can say get this energy, from the process of respiration. Plants use atmospheric O2 for the, you can say, breakdown of glucose, and they release the energy. So plants also undergo respiration for the formation of energy. And you know, they don't have any breathing organs. Okay, plants, you know, don't have any breathing organs like lungs and all, or you can say skin, for the respiration. But what happens is there is exchange of gases in plants by a simple process of diffusion. You know, the plants undergo exchange of gases, that means carbon dioxide move in and oxygen move out from the plants, the layers of the cells, by roots and stems, you know. And there is majority of exchange of gases is done in the stomata cells. You know, you can just see the opening of the stomata cells for exchange of gases. So from these small openings, there is exchange of gases done in the plants. So this is the respiration in plants. Next come the human respiratory system. You know, human beings have special respiratory system, and main organ which is involved in human respiratory system is the lungs. These lungs has bronchioles, and they have this small alveoli. So here the exchange of gases mainly takes place. Not only this, we can start with the nasal, means the first part of the respiratory system is the nostrils and the nasal cavity. Here unfiltered air is not fit to enter our lungs. So what happens is the dust particles and spores enter into the nasal cavity, and through mucus and hair, these nostrils trap the dirt and dust particles, and that filter the air, and it will go inside the body with aseptic. So aseptic air enters the respiratory system. Okay, now you can very well understand why it is not advisable to breathe through the mouth. You know, breathing through the nose protects us from various infections and diseases. Next comes the larynx and pharynx. You know, the nasal cavity leads to the pharynx, and from that means the air passes through and then goes to the pharynx, which is a rectangular block, or it can be also called as glottis. Okay, here. So this larynx is pharynx is the glottis, and the larynx is the epiglottis. The epiglottis prevents the entry of food into the windpipe. Okay, then comes the trachea, which is mainly responsible for responsible for closing while we swallow the food, so that it's opening when we breathe. Okay, larynx is also called as voice box. That means it produces the sound, and it stops the as it is on stop of the trachea, like this. Okay, trachea is also called as the windpipe. Next comes the bronchioles tube, where the air enters the lungs. Okay, then it is subdivided into small tubules called the bronchioles, and bronchioles have this mucus lining, and after that this bronchioles have this small hole like structures called as the alveoli, where the exchange of gases mainly takes place. And lungs are two in number in a body, as you can see here, and also they are elastic. The lungs are elastic in nature, they are pink in structure. Okay, and they are spongy as well as cone shaped. Okay, so the lungs are covered, and their lungs are also double walled membrane called as pleura membrane. Lungs are covered by double membrane called as pleura membrane, and bronchioles form a network of tubes, as you can see, which further divides into the alveolar ducts. You know, each lung contain about 300 million alveoli. 300 million alveoli. Now when oxygen reach air, enter the lungs and reach the alveoli, the blood in the capillaries take in the oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide and water. The waste products of the respiration are mainly the carbon dioxide and water. So what happens? Carbon dioxide is again given out by the lungs, okay, and the water is utilized by the body. So the exchange of gases takes place in the lungs. Now we'll see about the breathing mechanism. Now breathing mechanism is a breathing is a physical process, as we have seen earlier. So the air we breathe in, is O2, as we know, and the air that we breathe out is CO2. So the process of intake of O2 is inhalation, while when we give out CO2, that is carbon dioxide, is the exhalation. Now you know, inhalation, or you can say the inspiration, breathing means the entry of air or O2 into the lungs. That so what happens is this: during this process the muscles contract, and push the ribs down, upward and down. So this causes increase in the volume of chest cavity, and ultimately what happens, the diaphragm goes down during the inhalation, while during exhalation, or you can say during the expiration, what happens during this, the muscles relax and ribs move downwards and increases the volume of chest cavity, and this the air is pushed out through the respiratory tract, and due to this the diaphragm goes up. So this is the breathing mechanism. So students, in this session we have seen the respiration in the plants and the human respiratory system. Thank you.